Hi, and welcome back to the Envision Home at Last video series. We're on site today. We're talking with Jeff Disher from Disher Electric. Now, an electrician is one of the trades on site that needs to be licensed and certified. So first, let's talk about that. Jeff, what does that entail?
Well, first of all, you got to be accepted into the apprenticeship. The apprenticeship is 5 years long, but in between there and after that, you have to have continuing education. It's just not a matter of getting your license, it's a matter of maintaining that license and keeping the classes and the codes updated for your license.
So the important part of this is homeowners need to really pay attention to who it is that they're hiring to work on their job.
Sure.
Now here on site, we want to talk about what it takes to rough in a house. Behind us here is a pedestal. Jeff, walk us through this. How does this happen?
You have to find out really who would be serving your residents, whether it be a Wisconsin Public Service, Alliant Energy, or We Energies of that sort. But finding out who that is, and then an application has to be filled out by the homeowner or the contractor together. Fill that application out, get that in as soon as possible, and then pay any bills that may need to be paid for that to proceed. And then when we get the okay, the basement gets backfilled, we come in, we set the pedestal.
And that's ultimately then what triggers getting the power from the road to the house.
Exactly. Then the utility company will send in a contractor or do it themselves, trench in, bring in the wires and that, and then fire it up.
Tell me what's going on here.
Well, we've got our 200 amp service here. That's normal on a house, a residential house. We come in from the pedestal, we come down, this is where our circuits will come out of, whether it be the bathroom circuits, living room circuits, or bedrooms and all those.
So all these leads come down, They're actually running throughout the house. Now, why don't we explain to people how this system differs from the old system with fuses?
What we've got is a breaker system. They're new, up-to-dated. There's new codes to that too. There's arc fault breakers and panels equipped for all those things. We have breakers that trip and you can reset and it tells you that it's tripped.
Are all the circuits live and rough in, or is that later?
We'd not rough them in because we don't want accidentally turning on circuits that wouldn't. We do not want live circuits that don't have outlets in them that would be open and dangerous at that time. So
okay.
We won't do that until trim out or whatever. So
okay, and then at the final, then we'll get inspection of this. The actual inspector will come in and say, yeah, everything's good to go.
Yes, gets inspected to make sure that everything's up to code and everything else, that we put the arc fault breakers in place.
Why don't you explain what a homeowner can do to help you out?
Have them come through as a walkthrough, first of all, before we do rough in, but we also encourage them to get through and try to make sure they have all their plans set aside, specifics of what they're looking for in their home. We also look for cabinet drawings, whether it be that to their vanity drawings, their bathroom, the kitchen, and everything else. So it gives us an idea of what we're looking for and what we can plan for.
So that's gonna tell them where lighting's gonna be important for
sure.
You to rough in for,
yep.
Or you're gonna need to know where a range is or a microwave or refrigerator, all those things, so you know where those leads go, correct?
Exactly, yes. And,
okay.
And what they would need to plan for, whether it be electric oven or gas ovens and stuff like that. We also wanna make sure that the homeowner is aware of the different colors of devices, whether it be light almond, white, or ivory are the three basic ones, and then we come in and actually install them, so.
Okay, and they're bringing their lights generally to you, right?
Yeah, normally what that would be is they'll pick out their lights ahead of time, bring their lights, set them out in the place that they want, or at least mark them which part of the house they go to.
And then at that point, that's when you get your final inspection?
Yes, after we trim out and everything, we get final inspection, inspector comes in, make sure everything's up to code, and we go from there, so.
Okay, sounds good. I think that covers everything with electrical and residential, right?
Pretty much, yeah.
Okay, good. Well, I hope you found this information helpful. If you did, please subscribe to our YouTube channel or visit us on our website, which is envisionhomeatlast.com. We'll see you next time.